Hello all, this video is on uploading LM35 data to ThinkSpeak server using Arduino Ethernet Shield. Connecting LM35 to Shield is simple. Pin 1 of LM35 goes to 5V, third pin to ground and the middle one data pin to A0. Only 3 wires needed for connection. For internet access, the Ethernet Shield is directly connected to a RJ45 port on the TP-Link router. The internet service provider's cable is at the input of the router and the shield is connected to one of the ports, RJ45 ports. My PC is also connected to the same TP-Link router over Wi-Fi. Before plugging RJ45 cable to shield, connect the USB cable of Arduino to PC. Now connect the RJ45 cable and notice the array of LEDs. Now the hardware setup is over. To know the IP address, run cmd and then type in ipconfig/all. ipconfig /all. Here the gateway IP is 192.168.0.1, which is the IP of the router. We use this IP to configure the router. All clients connected to this router will be assigned IP in this range only, 192.168.0.xxx. Only the last byte will be changed. Open your browser and then type in 192.168.0.1. This is the gateway IP of the router. Provide username and password to access configuration of your router. Mine is TP-Link router. Admin is the username as well as the password. Click on DHCP and confirm that it is enabled. This dynamic host configuration protocol allots IP automatically to the clients connected to the router. Now click on DHCP clients list and you can see the VisNet client, which is our Ethernet Shield. The MAC address is displayed along with the IP allotted, but we want this IP to be static and unique to our shield. To do this, click on address reservation and then add new. Copy the MAC address of shield and paste it. Ctrl C to copy and Ctrl V to paste. This MAC address is the one we used in the Arduino code. Provide the IP we wanted to fix for shield, that is 192.168.0.150. Note that this is in the range of the gateway IP. Only the last byte is modified to 150. You need to restart your router to enable the changes made. Restart the router. And if you check the client list now, you can see the Ethernet Shield allotted 192.168.0.150, which is permanent and static. It will remain the same whenever connected to the router. Even if the power is switched off and on, this IP will be the same. Now let us configure the ThinkSpeak account, which is the server. Open the browser and sign in your ThinkSpeak account. Under channels, click my channels and then new channel. Here provide a name, description and field 1 name. We are going to use only the first field as temperature. So we select only the field 1 name. If you want public view, enable it and then save. Here I have created a LM35 temperature channel with name, description and field 1 is temperature. Public view is enabled. You can give any name and description, also a name to the field 1. Now click on the API key tab and note down the right API key. This is unique to your channel and to be included in your Arduino code. Your Arduino client will upload to this server according to this API key. Now let us see the Arduino code. Two header files are used, SPI.h and Ethernet.h. As Ethernet Shield communicates with Arduino using SPI bus, we include this SPI.h. Analog pin A0 is defined as data pin. Under network settings, you can leave the MAC address as it is. Unless there is more than one Ethernet Shield in the same network, you need not change this MAC address. The IP address is the one we reserved static for the shield, 192.168.0.150, and the gateway IP is the IP of the router, 192.168.0.1. Note the usage of comma instead of dot. Next we'll see the ThingSpeak settings. The ThingSpeak address is the domain name of ThingSpeak website, api.thingspeak.com, which is stored in a char array. And the right API key is replaced with your unique channel API. Now Ethernet client object is started. The name of the Ethernet client is client. And under void setup, serial.begin 9600 asserts the serial communication at baud rate 9600. Then ethernet.begin is passed on with the network parameters, MAC, IP, gateway and subnet. The Ethernet shield IP is now printed on serial monitor, and then the start Ethernet function is called on. This function checks out for MAC address. If MAC address is 0, then DHCP failed is printed, else it prints Arduino connected to network, and then the function returns to the loop section from where it is called. Before that it is called, and the control returns back there. And a void loop, the temperature calculation is done with the data from analog 0 and then converted to string type data. ThingSpeak accepts only string type data, so it is converted to string. The client response is then updated on serial monitor. To update data on ThingSpeak server, we call the update ThingSpeak function with parameter field 1 with analog pin 0 data. The function update ThingSpeak uses HTTP POST method to update data to ThingSpeak. The parameter is received as string type TS data, and the connection with ThingSpeak on port 80 is verified. POST request is a bundle of strings separated by new line. The first string is message start line with three elements, each separated by space. Post is the first element, space, and then /update, second element, and space, HTTP /1.1 is the version, and N is the new line. We can also use print line instead of print. After this message start line, we send different header fields which has information about our POST request. The header fields follow the message start line. The first header field is host, which is api.thingspeak.com, and the second header field is connection. We specify close as we want to close connection with server after we receive response. The third header field is a non-standard header usually preceded by X. Here we pause on the right API key of our ThingSpeak channel. Next header is the content type header. We use form.url encoded, which defines the body of HTTP message sent to the server. Finally, the content length header specifies the size of media going to be sent in bytes. That is defined by the tsdata.length. After header fields, we send the message body, which is the actual data we post to the server. The message body is separated from header field by two new lines. The server knows that we are done with the header field when it arrives at the two new lines. Now upload the code and then open the serial monitor. Here you can see the action, data being uploaded to ThingSpeak server. Under your ThingSpeak account, open the public view to see the graph plotted, the temperature graph plotted. You can also export the data in Excel format. One Excel file will be downloaded, and if you click on that, you can see the data with the different time and temperature in CSV format. All data uploaded is logged and can be used for further verification. Thank you for watching.